Hey everybody, it's Taken Grace, and love to bring you this tutorial series here. So I'm sure you guys saw the trailer. We're going to be doing a fully complete inventory system with the UI, as well as a health system as well. So that first video will be for the health system. We're going to be breaking this into two parts. First part, we're going to actually do the logic for the health system, and the second part, we're going to do the UI for the health. And let's get started. So a third-person template, we'll start with that. Name it whatever you need to name it. Hit create. All right, so we're inside our third-person template. First thing I like to do is just to clean up the content drawer. If you hit Control Space, you can bring that up. It's a quick shortcut here. So the third-person folder, I just don't like input and maps. I'm just going to move straight into content, and it'll say blah blah blah. I need to find or replace. Yeah, I say okay. The maps we are going to also move to content. Blueprints, we're going to move our third-person character. Well, first I'm going to rename him BP character, because that's... or player, sorry. BP player. Move that into characters. And our game mode, I'm just going to put in its own folder. New folder, game mode. Game mode, move here. Alright, and yes. Third-person, bye-bye, we don't need you. So we need to create a couple of things here. The first thing we're going to do is right-click, make a new folder, and call it UI. We'll open that up, and we're going to go into make a blueprint class here, and it's going to be a custom one here called HUD. There we go. So by default, the third-person template is going to be a C++ for the HUD class. We want to make one that we can actually edit the blueprints inside. So we're going to make select this, and we'll call it HUD class. But I'll make sure that capital L is not there, because that'll bug me the entire time when we do this tutorial. All right, we'll do that. And then the next thing we need to do is we need to go to our characters, right-click, blueprint class, player controller. We're making a player controller for the same reason we're making the HUD classes. The controller is in C++, and we need one for to write some code in. Player controller. Okay, let's go into our game mode. And now we need to actually change these. So whenever you call like get player character, get player controller in the blueprint editor, this is what it's referencing here. So we need to make sure that our HUD class is our HUD class that we just made. And then the player controller class will need to be the BP player controller. Hit compile, and then we're all done with that. And now we can actually get started with our inventory. Call it components. Components, hopefully I spelled that right. There we go, yep. Open that guy up. We're going to right click and go blueprint class actor component. So what a component is, obviously when we make our player character, we're going to be adding stuff like a collision sphere, a camera, movement. All those are components. So we're going to make a component that we can attach into a bunch of different blueprints. So you have a destructible item, you want to have some health. You have an enemy that you want to have some health. And obviously our player, we want to have some health. So we're going to make a component that's going to run all the logic for the health, and then we can plug it into whatever we want, and we only have to do the logic once. We'll call this health. We're going to click on that guy, bring this over here. So we're going to create a couple of variables. First few we're going to make, we'll do here. So we'll do a new variable. It's going to be a Boolean, and we're going to check if we're dead. Dead. Another one called current health, obviously to track the actual health of our object. Make it a float. Make another one, and we'll call it max health. So we obviously want to be able to upgrade our max health throughout the game, so we want to be able to change that dynamically. So these two should be instance editable. All right. So on event begin play, we're going to want to set our current health by holding alt and dragging out our max health, holding alt. Whoops, what happened there? Max health. Oh, I pushed space, not alt. Let's drag these up, and we're going to set them as themselves, because we're going to be editing them in each instance of the health component. So we want them to be set as whatever that is set as inside each object. We also want to get a reference to our HUD class. So we're going to get actor of class. We'll just type HUD class. The reason we're doing this is we want to be able to reference our HUD later to run some specific events. So we're going to promote this to a variable. We'll just name it HUD. And it's as easy as that. So we're going to make three functions now inside this health component. We're going to go here, add a new function. We're going to call it player, or sorry, just take damage. Take damage. because it's not necessarily our player just taking damage, it's whatever is implementing this component. We'll do gain health as a new function, one more function, and we'll call it death. Okay, let's start with take damage. We're going to be inside take damage. We're going to click on our input node, and we're going to add a input of a health, or sorry, damage. Jeez, why can't I spell damage today? There we go. That'll be a float. All right, so the first thing we want to do in this blueprint is we're going to want to check and see if we're dead. So we're going to drag this out. We're going to get dead. Another shortcut here, if you drag out of a Boolean and push B, it'll make a branch for you with it connected. So that saves you a bit of time. So obviously we want to check if we're dead. We do not want to take additional damage if we're dead. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to grab our damage, and we are going to we'll get a minus node, but we're gonna put the damage on the bottom one, and then we're gonna take our current health and we're gonna subtract that from our damage. So make sure current health is on top, or else you'll get a zero. And then out of this, we do want to set our current health. However, we don't want our current health to ever be lower than zero, because that might make us miss our dead event, because we're going to be checking in a second if we have zero health. So we're going to get a clamp. We're going to get clamp float. So this node will restrict the number to zero, and whatever the max is, in this case, which we are at max health. Anyways, from this value, we are going to set our current health. So we're going to come out of, dead, if we are not dead. So coming out of the false branch. And we're going to set that guy. Following our setting our current health, we are now going to check. We're going to drag out of here and get an equals node. Does it equal zero? If it does, that is not the right node. If it does, we are dead. So out of the true branch, we're going to grab our def function, and we're going to run that. And then if we are not dead, we are going to go return, and we'll plug that guy in, just like that. Okay, so that's take damage. Nothing too complicated. Okay, and next let's do, we'll get out of this, and we're going to do our gain health. Now gain health is going to be pretty much exactly the same, minus the death stuff, so we're going to do a float input, which is going to be health to add. Okay, from there we're going to obviously check that we're dead, because that'll be embarrassing if we gain health after we died. So once again, we'll drag out and push B. Okay, making sure we're not dead, and then we're going to set our current health from here, like that. All right, so health to add, we're going to add. And then we're going to do current health. And then once again, we'll add a clamp float. Make this one's important that we have max health actually plugged in, because we don't want to go past our max health. And that'll be the function. And then we'll do a return as well. Return. Boom, nice and easy. Finally, for the death one, we're going to learn about something new. So we'll get out of gear. We'll close gain health. We'll go inside death. For death, we're going to add a do once node. We only want to die once. We don't want gain health and, we don't want take damage running this a couple of times before it actually sets our death variable as true, which is the thing we're doing next. So we'll just drag this out. Set is dead to true. Okay. We'll do this in a second here. Actually, we'll do it now. In our event graph, in our event begin play, we want to make sure that we want to set is dead to false. Because if we die and then we respawn, this is going to be set as true, and then we'll run into some issues. So we just want to make sure that we're setting our dead as false from when we respawn back in. Okay, and finally, we're going to do what's called an event dispatcher. So what we can do here, so obviously, there's going to be different events running in all of the objects that are implementing this component. So we're going to add an event dispatcher to basically send a message out to whoever owns this component saying, hey, we died. Do something about it. So we're going to do on death is what we're going to call it. Okay, on death. Okay, we're going to grab on death, and we're going to drag it out here. And you'll see that when we drop it, it'll ask us these. So we want to call it. So calling it will trigger events to happen in our individual objects. Okay. All right. So we're going to hit compile. We are going to Go into our player character now. BP player. We are going to do one thing here first. So where it says add input mapping, we have this cast to player controller and get controller. These are referencing the old player controller. So we need to get rid of that. And we need to get player controller. Now we're getting our new controller. And we need to grab this and cast to BP player controller. Okay, so now we're getting our new controller. Plug all that in, plug all that in. And everything is going to be super good. All right, so the first thing we'll do here, we'll go down to the bottom here. We're going to, first of all, implement our health component. Health. We've now added this health component to our player, so we can click on it, hit compile. We're going to come over here. You can change your current health and your max. Okay, so now we have health set inside our player. It's not just 0, 0. And now that we have our health component over here, we can right-click, add event, add on death. So this is now we're going to tell what our player what to do when our health component calls this event. So the first thing, obviously, we want to do when we die is we want to get our player controller. And then out of here, we're going to disable input. Okay, and we're going to plug our player controller into the player controller. The target is self. This is our player. We want our player to not be able to receive input anymore. For some reason, there we go. Okay, and after that, we're going to want to do some really basic ragdoll. So we're going to grab our mesh for our character mesh. We're going to drag out of there, and we're going to set collision enabled. This guy here. Okay, and we want to set it as collision enabled query in physics. After that, we're going to grab our mesh. We'll drag it out to here, and we'll do R. We'll let go, and we'll do RER. Add reroute node, so you don't have to do that later. And we'll just drag out of it again, and we're going to set simulate physics. Okay, we're going to do that, and we're going to say true. Okay. All right, so when we die, we're going to disable our input. We are going to set our collision enabled as collision enabled, and then set simulate physics. Okay. So now that we've done these, we need to enable them by default, like kind of like we did with the dead and the health component. So we're going to make a new function. We'll call it player defaults. Okay, let's go to our event graph quick and add that before we forget. Okay, in a player defaults, we are going to add a sequence node because we're probably going to want to do a couple of things here. First thing we'll do is we will enable input. We will get player controller. We're going to drag them to the player controller. We're going to grab our mesh. We're going to set sim. So we're going to do this backwards. Set simulate physics is going to be false. Really, really important that these are in the right order. If we go back to our event graph and down here, if we set simulate physics first before we set the collision enabled, you're going to get some errors. It's going to say we can't, because this was the default, right? No collision. It's going to say we can't simulate physics because there's no collision enabled, right? So before you simulate physics, make sure you have this set properly and then simulate it. When you want to turn it off, make sure you disable the physics first and then do the set collision. Can't see my keyboard here. All right, so we don't want to do no collision. We do want to do query only, because that's what the default for the player character is. Okay, finally, we want to then just make a quick reference to our HUD, because we're going to reference it here. So we're going to just drag it here. We'll do get actor of class. It's going to be our HUD class. We're going to promote that to a variable, and we'll call it HUD. All right, so that is all the logic done for our health component. So in the next video, we're going to do the actual UI for our health so we can see it all work in action. If you guys like the video, please subscribe. We have a whole tutorial series going on here where we're going to make an inventory system with a bunch of items, which comes with free meshes, a bunch of other stuff. So see you guys in the next video.